WKBN 27 First News starts now with breaking news.
More details about the shooting in Niles. Police still on the scene. It was an officer-involved shooting, and right now we know one person is dead, not a police officer. But investigators still have lots of questions. Now, the incident started around 2:30 at Niles Municipal Court. It ended a short time later near the Royal Mall Apartments right off of Route 46.
That's when 27 First News anchor Stan Boney rushed to the scene. He's been there ever since. He's live tonight and begins our breaking news coverage.
Well, it is still very much an active crime scene here at the Royal Mall Apartments in Niles, where earlier this afternoon at around 2-3 o'clock, there was a shooting incident here at the apartments involving Niles police officers and a suspect. None of the Niles police officers were hurt. Nobody standing by was hurt, though the suspect was killed. And in fact, they are still investigating the situation that is taking place behind me. The best that we can put together, again, is all this happened right around 3 o'clock this afternoon. I did talk with people on the scene here who say they heard several shots in rapid fire. Some people saying as few as five, others saying as many as seven shots took place. It happened here, and that's when the suspect was killed. Nobody actually that I talked with today actually saw the crime happen itself, but we did get people talking about it and what they heard. And this is what one woman heard at the incident, or as it happened, earlier this afternoon.
I was in the house and we heard about six gunshots. I thought it was fireworks at first, and then we seen everybody running up front here, you know, running around in a circle and stuff. And everybody just came up here, and every siren and every police car in Niles, I think, was here, ambulances and everything.
Now, none of the names of anyone involved with this incident have been released as of yet, not the suspect or the officers involved in the shooting. The Bureau of Criminal Investigation, the Trumbull County Coroner, they are both on the scene. We did ask the coroner if the name of the suspect would be released tonight. We were told it will most likely happen tomorrow. Now, also, the Niles Police Department has also talked about what they believe happened today. And joining me now is Molly Reed. She talked with Captain John Marshall of the Niles Police Department earlier today. Molly, what did he have to say?
Stan, I was talking to Captain John Marshall, and he gave me a brief timeline of exactly what happened today. He told me at around 2:30, the suspect entered Niles Municipal Court. We're not told why he was at court today, but he went and talked to a probation officer. He apparently had a warrant out for his arrest from charges dating back to December. Apparently, they were assault charges. We're told that the probation officer recognized him, possibly saw that he knew, recognized him from having a warrant out, and then attempted to detain him. At that point, the suspect started fleeing from the court. Apparently, when they were in the parking lot at some point while the officer was trying to detain him, the suspect almost hit this probation officer with his car. This is what dispatchers then did from that point on.
Dispatcher put out an alert for that vehicle, and officers went to the address that came back in order to try to locate the subject that had left the court. At some point, the subject met the officers there, and an incident occurred, and there was an officer-involved shooting at that point.
And again, from that point on is what Stan was saying. At some point, there was some sort of altercation, and the suspect was shot here at the Royal Mall Apartments. Now, again, the scene is still very active behind me. You can see the police are still here. They're looking into exactly what unfolded here. We are told that the officers who were involved in this shooting will be on administrative leave. That's part of the protocol, though. So as they're searching and looking into this, that's what's going to be happening as far as the department. Again, we are not told when they will officially release the suspect's name. It could be tonight, it could be tomorrow morning. That's something that you'll have to stick with us here at WKBN as we learn to figure out. But for now, in Niles, Molly Reed, WKBN 27 First News.